Hello everybody, today we are going to finish the three buttons up. It's supposed to show us three buttons, and when you click different buttons, you see how many clicks the user did. So far we have fields. Let me increase a little bit the size, so we declared three widgets. We did instantiation, find view by ID, very important statement, and we registered three buttons so we can process clicks from them. In order to test clicks, we just used toast. So this step sometimes called wiring. You're just testing your event handlers. Now let's complete the application logic. So I have to count clicks. So I'm gonna add three integer variables. Let's copy paste. So I declared behind widgets three integer variables. I put zeros in those variables, so when my application starts, the number of the clicks is zero. And sometimes we call this part of your app is, we call it model. This part of your app, sometimes we call it view. And event handler, we call it controller. So in many computer books, you will see this term MVC. Model View Controller. Visual part of your app, what user can see. Sometimes it's called view, mathematic model, numbers, behind widgets, we call them model. And finally, the event handler, the coding to process clicks, it's a controller. So MVC, very popular term in programming. So after I have three integer variables, I can go to my event handler. I don't need toast. It was needed just for testing. And first step, I need to understand from which button I received the message. So right now this handler connected to all three buttons. This parameter view is the address of the button which was clicked. Any button has ID, so I can check it. If So if the top button was clicked, you see how you can check. You get from the view ID, you compare ID with the BTN top. Don't forget, you declare BTN top in XML on design stage. So if it's top, I increase top clicks. And then I have to finish my method. There is nothing to do. I'm done. I don't have to do anything. So return is end of method. But of course I have to also analyze two other situations when it's middle button and when it's bottom. So I'm just copying and pasting. I don't need return in the last if because it's the end of the method. And look at the end of the coding, you see three curly braces. You have to understand which one belongs to what structure. So this is end of if. This is end of your method. And finally, this curly brace is the end of your class. So, we use two very important methods here, how to get ID for any widget and how to change the text of any widget. First method get ID, second method set text. So, basically, I can test now. My app, let's try. So you've seen it. You see my app is working right now. I'm just cleaning a little bit my coding. The placement of your statements and your curly braces is important. So be careful with those indents. How you place curly braces, opening curly braces, closing curly braces. So you've seen it's working. My buttons show me the number of the clicks. And before we finish today's lesson, just a very common error you may have. Sometimes you just forget to instantiate your widget. You forget about Find View by ID. So I comment one line. And now watch what's going to happen. So you see message, your app has stopped. You see the message, your app has stopped. It's a very common issue. Don't be afraid. Don't panic. You just forgot to instantiate the widget. And instantiation done through Find View by ID. So not only declare your widgets, instantiate your widgets. It's a very common problem when your application has stopped. Read your code and fix it. So let's review quickly the coding we did today. So the top line of your file is package for any app you create. Android Studio create unique package. Import statements needed to connect library classes. You see whatever class from Android library you use, you're going to use import. This is inheritance. I extend a library class app compat activity. This is interfaces. Remember, you can implement many, not just one, many interfaces in your app in order to catch events. Fields. Initiation, registration. Also, don't forget to register the buttons, otherwise they won't trigger the events. And finally, this is your event handler, your application logic. So, congratulations, we did a first mobile app, and I would say the most probably challenging part of the course is finished. It was about concepts, ideas, definition, terms, Java, events. So next lessons, I'm going to just add more simple apps to my course. But the most important, the most challenging, the most serious part is done. It's covered now. We're just going to try different widgets, different events, different simple apps. Thank you very much for watching me. Good luck and wait for the next lessons. Bye-bye.